Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to my YouTube channel Calculus and Mathematics Learning. In the previous video, I commenced and started with ETA Engineering Test of 2017 Mathematics portion. In the previous video, I solved the first 10 MCQs related with ETA Engineering Test of 2017 Mathematics portion. In today's video, I am going to solve the next MCQs related with Mathematics portion of ETA Engineering Test of 2017. So let's move toward the MCQ number 11 of ETA Engineering Test of 2017 Mathematics portion. It tells that 1 over 6 factorial plus 2 divided by 7 factorial plus 3 divided by 8 factorial, it is equal to which value? So 4 options are given for this MCQ. So taking the given 1 over 6 factorial plus 2 divided by 7 factorial plus 3 divided by 8 factorial. Now you know that n factorial is equal to n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 and goes on. This is actually the n factorial. So over here, 1 over 6 factorial will comes down as it is plus 2 divided by, if we look over here, n is decreasing by 1 successively. So over here, this 7 factorial can be written as just like 7 into 6 factorial. We just decrease it by 1 just like according to n factorial. Now using the same property over here, it becomes 3 divided by 8 can be written as 8.7.6 factorial. Now after this, I take 1 over 6 factorial common. So by taking 1 over 6 factorial common from over here, we left with 1. And from over here, I take 1 over 6 factorial common, we left with 2 by 7. So it becomes 2 divided by 7. Now from over here, if I take 1 over 6 factorial common, I left with 3. And divided by 8 multiply 7, it gives us 56. So now from over here, I simplify just like 1 over 6 factorial into this one can be written as 7 divided by 7. It again gives us 1 plus 2 divided by 7, and after this plus 3 divided by 56. So now after this, it become 1 over 6 factorial into, I take the LCM up to 7 by 7 and 2 by 7. So by taking LCM 7, in the numerator I left with 7 plus 2, it gives us 9. And after this, plus 3 divided by 56. So now after simplification, it become 1 over 6 factorial and take the LCM of 7 and 56. So let's suppose 8 LCM is 56. So 7 multiply 8 gives us 56. So multiply the same 8 with 9, it will give us 72 and plus 3. So it will give us the result of 1 over 6 factorial, 6 factorial, 1 over 6 factorial into 72 plus 3, it gives us 75 and divided by 56. So now after this, 56 can be written as just like 1 over 6 factorial into 75 will come down as it is, and 56 can be written as 8 multiply 7. So again using this property, 8 multiply 7 multiply 6 factorial, just like we split it 8, 7, 6 factorial, we split it from 8 factorial. So 8 into 7 into 6 factorial can be written as 8 factorial over here. So the result over here, 1 over 6 factorial, 6 factorial into 8 into 7 can be written as just like 8 factorial. Because 8 factorial can be written as 8 multiply 7 and multiply 6 factorial. So we just write it in 8 factorial form. Now in the numerator we have 75, so it will comes down as it is. It means the result to this MCQ is 75 divided by 8 factorial. So the correct option for this MCQ is option number C. Now move to the next MCQ related with ETA Engineering Test of 2017. MCQ number 12, it tells that the objective function in a linear programming is usually denoted by which function? 4 options are given. Remember, objective function are those function in a linear programming which is used to maximize or minimize the variable used in the linear inequality. And it is represented by the function f of xy is equal to ax plus by, where a and b must belong to the real number. It means the correct option for this MCQ is option number B. Move to the next MCQ number 13. The non-negative constraint in a linear programming, the linear problem is used by. So the variable used in the linear inequality is actually called a non-negative constraint, and that variable are x and y, and they must be greater than or equal to 0. So in option number B, x is greater than or equal to 0 and y is also greater than or equal to 0. So that's why these are actually the non-negative constraint used in the linear programming in a linear inequality. So the correct option for this MCQ is option number B. Move to the next MCQ number 14. It tells that numerical methods are used for the solution of linear equation, quadratic equation, cubic equation, and linear equation. Remember, numerical methods are always used for the solution of non-linear equations. So the correct option for the MCQ number 14 is option number D. Move to the next MCQ, the MCQ number 15. Find the value of limit xy approaches to negative 1 and 1. Find the value of x square divided by x square plus y square plus 2. So using the limit directly, so applying the limit on the this fraction or this function, so it become x is negative 1 over here. So putting negative 1, so it become negative 1 whole square divided by x. So x is negative 1, so it become negative 1 square. And plus y square, y is 1, so it become 1 square, and plus 2 will comes down as it is. By simplification, it becomes minus 1 square gives us 1, divided by minus 1 square gives us 1, 1 square gives us 1, and plus 2 will comes down as it is. So the result will be 1 divided by 2 plus 1 plus 1, it gives us 4. So this is actually the required and desired answer. So the correct option for this MCQ is option number A. Move to the next MCQ, MCQ number 16. Now it tells that the degree of homogeneous function f of xy is equal to under root of x plus under root of y divided by x plus y will be. Four options are given, 1, 0, 1 over 2 and negative 1 over 2. Move to the solution of this MCQ. A function will be homogeneous function if it defines this definition, which tells that f of lambda x and lambda y will be equal to lambda power n into f of xy. Then this n is actually the degree of the homogeneous function. Now our original function is f of xy is equal to root of x plus root of y divided by x plus y. Now according to the definition, we will replace x with lambda x and y with lambda y. So it becomes f of lambda x and lambda y. Replace x with lambda x and y with lambda y. X with lambda x and y with lambda y. Now in the numerator, take out under root lambda common. So over here we left with under root x. And here if we take out lambda under root common, we left with under root of y. And in the numerator, if we take out lambda common, we left with x plus y. Now after simplification, lambda power over here is 1 over 2 and over here the lambda power is 1. So by moving to the numerator, power will become negative 1 and under root x plus under root y divided by x plus y will come down as it is. As this is actually the original function, which is f of xy. So it becomes lambda power 1 over 2 minus 1 gives us negative 1 over 2 into f of xy is equal to f of lambda x lambda y. Comparing with the standard form of f of lambda x lambda y is equal to f of xy lambda power n. Hence the lambda power of lambda is negative 1 over 2. It means that the homogeneous degree of this function is negative 1 over 2, so the correct option for this MCQ is option number D. Now move toward MCQ number 17 related with ETA engineering test of 2017. It tells that which one of the following expresses the periodic property. So in four option we have sine theta given. It means that first we will draw the graph of sine theta. So this is actually the graph of sine theta. If we look at this graph of sine theta, the sine theta repeat their value at 2 pi. Over here look at 2 pi, negative 2 pi, and over here look at 2 pi. So it means that from 0 to 2 pi and from 0 to negative 2 pi, the sine repeat its value. So we see that the graph of sine theta keeps repeating itself after the period of 2 pi. It means that the period of sine theta is 2 pi. So in this option we have not 2 pi, in this option we have 2 pi, in this option we have pi pi. So these C and D and A are we neglect. So the correct option for this MCQ is option number B, which tells that sine into theta plus minus 2 pi is equal to sine theta. It means that the sine theta repeats their value after the interval of 2 pi. So the correct option for this MCQ is option number B. Move to the next MCQ number 18. In the equation y square is equal to 4 px. So if p is greater than 0, then the parabola will symmetric with the negative x axis, positive y axis, positive x axis, and x axis. Remember, if we have y square is equal to 4px, then the directrix of this equation will be x is equal to negative p. This is the first point. And also the second point is this. So we will look at the right hand side of the y square. So over here we have x. So it means that this parabola is lie along x axis. So we will neglect the y x axis option. So we have two options, negative x axis or positive x axis. Over here we have positive parabola y square is equal to 4px. It means that this parabola lies along positive x axis. Over here we have the equation just like y square is equal to negative 4px, then the parabola will be negative x axis. But over here this is positive, it means that this parabola lie along positive x axis. So the correct option for MCQ number 18 is option number C. Now move toward MCQ number 19 of ETA Engineering 2017. It tells that in the horizontal ellipse, so a foci are h minus c and k. This is, let's suppose, foci number 1 and foci number 2 is h plus c into k. Then the standard form of the para ellipse equation will be, so for the horizontal ellipse, so the equation is x minus h whole square divided by a square plus y minus k whole square by b square is equal to 1. The correct option for this MCQ is option number C. Move to the next MCQ, MCQ number 20. It tells that in the translation of axis, direction of axis changes, origin is changing, both axis and origin are changes, axis are changing through some angle. Remember, there are three types of transformation. The first is the translation of x-axis in which just origin changes. So for this MCQ, the correct option is option number B. And the second one is actually the rotational x-axis. In the rotational x-axis, you know, the direction is changes without changes in the origin of the system. And the third one is general transformation, in which both the direction and both the origin of the system is changes. But over here we are talking about the translation of x-axis. So that in the translation of x-axis, just origin is changing. So the correct option for this MCQ number 20 is option number B.